Avenue. In today's lecture, we are going to start or we are going to solve next problems in the exercise 6. Okay. Problem number 44. The product of 36 into dash into box is divisible by 16. Which smallest number should replace the box? Means which smallest number should occupy the place of box? Okay, that means 36 multiplied by dash is divisible by 16. Okay, so here we have to find such a smallest number which when multiplied with 36, then the product which will get that will be divisible by 16. Okay, so how to do that? How to find that smallest number? Okay, see you. Now see, here the product which we will get, it will be in the table of 36, right? Then 36 1 the 36, it may be 36 2 are, 36 3 are, 36 4 are, or 36 5 are, 7 are, whatever. That the product which we will get, product, that is 36 into dash, the product which we will get, it will be in table of 36, correct? As it is in table of 36, that means it will be divisible by 36, right? And again, see, this product is also divisible by 16. The product will be divisible by 16 also, right? And we have to put smallest number in the box. So the product which we will get, it will be the smallest number which will be divisible by both 36 and 16. Smallest number which will be divisible by both 36 and 16. Understood? Once again I repeat, see here. We have to find product of 36 into dash. Okay. So the product of this, whatever we will get, it will be, obviously it is in table of 36, so it will be divisible by 36. Okay, and it is divisible by 16 also, as given in the problem. It is divisible by 16 also. So the product will be divisible by both 36 and 16. And as we have to put your smallest number, so the product which we will get, it will be smallest number divisible by both 36 and 16. And you know, smallest number which is divisible by both 36 and 16 means what it will be? It will be LCM. Lowest or least common multiple. It will be common multiple. Lowest common multiple of 16 and 36. Okay. So see here, the product of 36 and the smallest number will be LCM of lowest common multiple of 36 and 16. Understood why? Lowest common multiple means it is in table of 36 also, and it, as it is divisible by 16, so it is in table of 16 also. Lowest common multiple, that is LCM. So first what we will do, you know, we will find LCM of 36 and 16. Okay, so let's find LCM of 36 and 16. First, we will do prime factorization. 36 is divisible by 2, right? 2 18s are 36. Further, 2 9s are 18. Again, 9 is divisible by which prime number? 3, correct? So, 3 3s are 9 and 3 1s are 3. Because 3 is prime number itself, so it will be divisible by itself. Let's find prime factors of 16. 16 is divisible by 2. 2 8s are 16. 2 4s are 8. 2 2s are 4. And 2 1s are 2. Okay. So the factors of 36 are 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Whereas factors of 16 are 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Let's find common factors. 2 and 2 common. Here they are non-common. Okay. So LCM, you know, LCM is what? Nothing but common factors as well as non-common factors. So LCM of 36 and 16 is first mandal, take common factors 2 and 2, 2 into 2 into non-common, 3 into 3 into 2 into 2, okay, that is 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, 12 3s are 36, 36 2s are 72 and 72 2s are 144. You can do multiplication on the page to check, okay, 144. So 144 is the product of 36 and whatever number will be here, the product of these two numbers, okay. Now, so to find this number, what we have to do with the 144? We have to divide 144 by 36. Now see, since 36 into dash is equal to 144, so box is equal to 144 divided by, I mean, 36 is multiplied here, right? So 36 will come on this side, opposite side, it will be divided. So now 144 divided by 36. If you divide 144 by 36, what number will you get? You know, 36 1s are 36, 36 2s are 72, 36 3s are 108. You can do that. And 36 4s are, see, 4 6s are 24, 4 3s are 12, and 2 14. 144. 36 4s are 144. So 144 divided by 36 is 4. So which number will occupy the box, or which number, which smallest number should replace the box? It is 4. So 4 is the smallest number which will replace the box, which should replace the box. Okay, what we have done first, you know that product, the product which we will get here, it, that product will be LCM of 36 and 16, because it will be in table of 36 and it is divisible by 16, so it will be in table of 16 also. So it is the lowest common multiple of both 36 and 16. Okay, so we have found LCM of 36 and 16, that was 144. And to find 144, to get 144 as a product, we need to multiply 36 by 4. So we have got answer 4. Understood? Next. Similarly, see the second question number 45. To obtain a number divisible by both 42 and 45, by which smallest number should 105 be multiplied? Now see here. To obtain a number divisible by both 42 and 45, we have to find such number which is divisible by both 42 and 45. So the number which is divisible by both 42 and 45 means it should be common multiple of 42 and 45, right? Common multiple. And as we have to find a smallest number, by which we will multiply 105, so that we will get that common multiple of 42 and 45. Okay, so that common multiple must be least common multiple, lowest common multiple, LCM of 42 and 45. So the number must be, the number which is divisible by both 42 and 45 must be LCM of 42 and 45. Okay, so let's find LCM of 42 and 45 by prime factorization method. So 42 is divisible by 2, right? 2 2s are 4, 2 1s are 2. Then 21 is divisible by 3, 3 7s are 21. And 7 is prime number itself, so 7 1s are 7. Okay. 45 is divisible by 5 or 3 also. 3 1 3 1 3 3 5 15 53 3 45 see 53 3 45 that means 3 15 are 45 again 15 is divisible by 3 3 5 is a 15 5 1 is a 5 because 5 is prime number itself so 42 is equal to 2 into 3 into 7 whereas 45 is equal to there is no 2 directly 3 into 3 into 5 common is 3 correct so LCM of 42 and 45 is common multiples 3 sorry common factors 3 and all are non common 2 into 7 into 3 and 5 okay so let's multiply 3 5s are 15 okay 15 7s are 105 105 2s are 105 2s are how you multiply 105 100 2s are 200 5 2s are 10 210 okay and 210 3s are now see 210 into 3 so 200 3s are 2 3s are 6 so 200 3s are 600 and 10 3s are 30 630 so the LCM is nothing but 630 okay 5 3s are 15 15 7s are 105 105 2s are 210 210 3s are 630 so this is the number this is the number which is divisible by both 42 and 45 or this is the lowest number why we have found lowest number only LCM only there can be many numbers which will be divisible by both 42 and 45 but why we have found here lowest common multiple only because we have to find smallest number that should 105 be multiplied by which 105 be multiplied so we have found here LCM so now see since 105 multiplied by dash is equal to 630 so we have to multiply 105 by the smallest number so that we will get 630 it is same problem the same both problems are same just little language is changed okay same see now see find the box means unknown number missing number we need to divide 630 by 105 transpose rule of transposition we have used here multiplication the 105 was multiplied on this side on the left side to find box what we have done this one on multiplied by 105 we brought on the other side so as soon as it changed its sign so we had changed its sign also so multiplication changed to division okay I have told you this earlier 630 divided by 5 what we will get you know 100 105 means 105 and this is 630 means 600 plus 30 okay so you know 100 6 are 600 and 5 6 are 30 correct so 105 see what answer you will get 105 6 are see 6 5 are 30 6 0 is 0 and 3 6 1 is 6 see right 6 so 630 divided by 105 is nothing but 6 so by which number we have to multiply by which smallest number we have to multiply 105 so by 6 is the smallest number by which 105 should be multiplied. Okay. So now pause this video. Write both the problems in your notebook. After these two more problems, we are going to see. Okay. See problem number 46. When a 5-digit number is divided by 27 or 23 or 11, remainder is 5. 5 such smallest 5 digit number. Okay, now see this problem. What we have to find actually? We have to find such a smallest 5 digit number, or such a 5 digit number which when divided by 27 or 23 or 11, it leaves remainder 5. Okay, such 5 digit, smallest 5 digit number we have to find. Okay, now see that number which we will get, that number must be divisible by 27, 23 and 11 when 5 subtracted from E. Are you getting? One example I will give you. See here, 3 numbers are there, 3, 5 and 7. Okay, so then the number which is divisible by this 3 numbers, it will be what? Their LCM. And in this LCM, when we add the remainder, then we will get the expected number. For example, their LCM is 7, 5 is 35, 35, 3 is 105. Okay, 105 is their LCM. And suppose it is leaving remainder 3. Okay, so the number will be 108. So the this problem is now like this. See, find the smallest 3 digit number, we can say, which is divisible by which when divided by 3 or 5 or 7 leaves remainder 3. So the number is 108. Okay, so how to find this 108? First, what we have to do, we have to find LCM of these 3 numbers, and in that we have to add remainder. Okay, now see here, this problem is saying like this. What we are going to do first? First we will find LCM of 27, 23 and 11. So we will get LCM, it may be 3 digit or 4 digit or directly 5 digit. Okay, if we are getting LCM of 5 digit, then it is well and good. But if you are getting LCM less than 5 digit, so that is, it may be of 4 digit, then what we have to do? We have to multiply that LCM by 2, so that we will get next number which is divisible by both these, and in that we have to add the remainder. Okay, so let's first find LCM of let's find LCM of 27, 23 and 11. Okay, LCM will be divisible by 27, 23 and 11, all these 3 numbers. So now see, 23 and 11 are prime numbers, right? So their prime factors will be 23 and 11 itself. Let's first find prime factors of 27. 3 9s are 27, 3 3s are 9 and 3 1s are 3, okay? And 23 itself, divisible by itself, because it is prime number, and also 11 divisible by 11 itself. So now see here, 27 is equal to 3 into 3 into 3, 23 is equal to 23 itself, and 11 is equal to 11. Okay, now so LCM of 27, 23 and 11 is, there is no any common factor. So multiply out 3 into 3 into 3 into 23 into 11. Okay, 23 and 11 are 230 plus 11, 241. Okay, 23 and 11 are 241. Fine. Sorry, 23 tens are 230 plus 23, 253. Okay, now this 3 into 3 into 3, 27. 27 threes are 81. 1 will come down, 8 will be carried. If you don't know table of 27, what you have to do, you will give a multiply by individual digit. Now 27 5s are 135, right? 135 plus 8. 135 plus 8 is 140. 3 will come down, 14 will be carried. 27 plus 27, 27 2's are 54. 54 plus 14, 54 plus 14, 68. Correct? 54, 64, 68. 6831. So the LCM is 6831. This is the number, or smallest number, which is divisible by 27, 23 and 11. But what is the problem? This is not 5-digit number. This is not 5-digit number. Then first what we have to do? We will multiply to get smallest 5-digit number. Which is divisible by 27, 23 and 11. What we have to do, we need to multiply 6831 by 2. 2 and the 2, 2 3's are 6, okay. 2 and the 2, 2 3's are 6, 2 8's are 16, 6 will come down, 1 will be carried, 2 6's are 12 and 1 13. 13,662. So this is the smallest 5-digit number which is exactly divisible by these 3 numbers. But we have to find the number which when divided by these 3 numbers leaves remainder 5. So to find that number, so the expected number is, expected number means the number which when divided by the number which when divided by 27 or 23 or 11, the smallest 5-digit number which when divided by 27, 23 and 11 leaves remainder 5. Okay, this number, this is the smallest 5-digit number which is exactly divisible by this 3 number. So to find the number which leaves remainder 5, we have to add 5 in this. So 13,662 plus 5, that is 13,667. Okay, this is the expected number. Okay, now see problem number 47. By which largest number should 78, 104 and 130 be divided so that the remainders will be 3, 4 and 5 respectively? Means what? We have to find such a highest number, such one highest number. If we divided that highest number to 78, we get remainder 3. If we divided same highest number by 144, we get remainder 4. And if we divided by same number to 130, we get remainder 5. Understood? So one such number, that is common factor, highest common factor of highest common factor of the number, the numbers where we will subtract this remainder from 3 from 78, 4 from 104, 5 from 130. Okay, so those new numbers will obtain its highest common factor. We have to find that is HCF. Okay, see this concept again. We have to find such one highest number, common number, which will divide into 78, remainder 3. If you divide it to 104 by that number, remainder 4. If you divide it 130 by that number, you get remainder 5. So these 3 numbers are not exactly divisible by that number. To become exactly divisible by that number, what you have to do? We have to subtract these remainders from these respective numbers. Okay? So see here, as when we divided 78, when we divide 78 by that number, it leaves remainder 3. That means 3. So when we subtract 3 from 78, the number which we get, 75. This 75 is exactly divisible by that number. Okay? Means what? See now, when we get remainder, if we divide 78 by that x number, Then remainder is getting 3. Remainder is getting 3. That means here must be 75, right? So the 75, x whatever, x, these are 75. Whatever this number will be. X, these are 75. Means 75 is in table of this number. That means 75 is divisible by that number. Okay. Similarly, 104 is there. So 104 is not exactly divisible by that number. It leaves remainder 4, that means when you subtract this remainder from 104, what we are getting? 100. 100 is exactly divisible by that. Similarly, 130 is not divisible by that number. As it leaves remainder 5, so when you subtract 5 from 130, we get 125. 125 is exactly divisible by that number. So this 75, 100 and 125 is exactly divisible by that highest number. So that number is highest common factor of 75, 100 and 125. Okay. So the number is HCF or GCD of 75, 100 and 125. Understood this concept? Once again I repeat, see, three numbers are there, 78, 104 and 130. To these three numbers, when we divide by one largest number, in that process it leaves remainder 3, 4 and 5 respectively. Okay? So these three numbers are not exactly divisible by that highest number. So that what we have done, these remainders are subtracted from these numbers respectively, and the new numbers which are obtained after subtracting remainder, these three numbers are exactly divisible by that number. Such highest number we have to find, so it is HCF of these three numbers. So let's find HCF of these three numbers. You know how to find HCF? We can use short division method also, as there are three numbers, 75, 100 and 125. Okay, so both all three numbers are divisible by which prime number? 5. 5 ones are 5. Divide it carefully. 75 divided by 5, if you have done division wrong, then you will not get exactly HCF. Okay? So divide carefully, divide a rough page if here not possible for you. 5 ones are 5, 7 minus 5, 2 remain. 25, so 5 5s are 25. See, 15 5s are 75. Check again, cross check, okay? 100 divided by 5, 5 2s are 10, 5 0s are 0. 25 is 100, see. 125 divided by 5, 5 2s are 10, 12 minus 10 is 2, 25 5s are 25. That is 25 5s are 125, again. Again, 15, 20 and 25 are divisible by which prime number? 5, right? 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 20, 5 5s are 25. 3, 4, 5, now these are, there is no common prime factor of these three numbers. So the HCF of 75, 100 and 125 is, these are common factors, right? Common prime factors. So HCF means multiplication of common prime factors. Below be the numbers which we get, they are non-common prime factors. Okay? That we have going to see in the LCM. 5 5s are 25. 5 into 5, that is 5 5s are 20. So 25 is the expected number. If we divide it 78 by 25, you can check here, 78 divided by 25. 3s are 75, correct? So 8 minus 5, 3. See, we got remainder 3. If you divide 104 by 25, 25 4s are 100, correct? 4, 0, 0. See, we get remainder 4. And similarly, if you divide 130 by 25, 25 5s are 125. 30 minus 25, 5. Remainder 5. Okay? So 25 is the number by which we can divide 78, 104, and 130. We get remainders 3, 4, and 5 respectively. So, when such type of problem is asked, what we have to do? First, subtract the remainders from the respective numbers, and the new numbers which we will be obtained find LCF of these new numbers. Okay. So hope you have understood this. If you have any problem in this, you can ask me and write this in your notebook. Last one problem number 48. You have to solve by yourself. Okay. So here our third chapter divisibility is completed. Okay. After that we'll start new lesson. Before that we'll conduct tests also. So thank you for today and have a nice day.